Hi there! Finally I'm back with another project to share with you. When I finished my turntable for automated 360 degree photography, the logical consequence for a maker was to create something that can be put on top of that turntable. And that's exactly why I started to create my own custom-made robot. So far I've prepared several laser-cut MDF prototypes of different robot heads and of one robot chassis. As you see, I started with a clear focus on the robot's personality, meaning the head, the face and
the eyes.
My aim was to create monochrome eyes in the typical robot pop culture style, as they can be seen in the movie Wall-E or at robot toys like Cosmo or Vector. I wanted the eyes to be fluidly animated, offering several mood expressions with smooth movements and transitions between all different states. Additionally, I wanted to be able to realize several different eye shapes that can simply be defined through a set of generic variables. With that purpose in mind, I wrote a dedicated library that made all of this possible. Let's have a look at it. Okay, so this is a simple test circuit to show the current features of the Robo Eyes library. There is an Arduino Nano, a small OLED display, a joystick, and some buttons. And what we see here already is two features in action. The autoblinker and the idle mode. The autoblinker blinks the eyes in a previously set interval, which is here 3 seconds at minimum, plus an additional random value from 0 to 2 seconds. Also, the idle mode is set, which means there is a dynamic macro animation running that changes the position of the eyes randomly every 1 to 4 seconds. Furthermore, there are 3 different mood types implemented so far, like tired or sad, angry or bad, and happy. And I hope you can see there are transitions between all the different styles, also between the positions and so on. Everything is tweened. That was important to me. And yeah, to add more life, there are several micro animations available, such as laughing. This is the first one here. And this fits perfectly to this kind of mood here. Happy and laughing, right? You could also do it the other way around. So if you want to go from sweet to bad, let's use the angry mode here and add the laughing here. And it's like... Okay, let's go back to neutral. Next is the confused animation. It's like the robot was crashing against an obstacle or so and is confused. And by the way, I think it's pretty obvious that there's some kind of glitch when performing fast movements on such displays. When I saw that first, I didn't even try to find a solution for this because I think it fits perfectly to the low fidelity style of the whole thing here. So I would say the glitch is a feature and it's not a bug. Next is the flicker animation, which adds an alternating offset of 1 pixel into each direction. And this works perfectly to emphasize the different mood types. If I go for tired, this is a normal tired, and I add the flicker. This can be interpreted as some kind of shivering, the robot is cold, or even really fearful, whatever. Normal angry style here, and angry even before the explosion. Happy, pretty happy. Last but not least, let's talk about the eyes configuration panel. Because due to the fact that we don't want every robot look the same, we can change the geometry for each eye. But to keep things simple here, all changes here are applied to both eyes at once, even if you could do that separately. Let's make the eyes a bit narrower by decreasing the width. And maybe I want to change the border radius. If you want to have sharp edges, it could look like this. You could also change the space between, and this can be also negative values. Let's start with the negative values. This is a more cartoony style, I would say. Yeah, also there is a Cyclops mode that makes sense if you only want to have one eye. You can just turn the second eye off and everything else still works. It can be laughing, it can be confused, can flicker. Also, the mood types work, but with some compromises being made because, yeah, it's just one eye to convey the certain mood. This would be the tired or sad mood. This would be the angry style. And this would be the laughing style. The last thing to show here is the curious mode. This is something we already know from the Cosmo robot. Currently, when the eyes are moving to the very left or the very right, their size remains the same. With the curious mode on, the size of the respectively outer eyes increases.
Hey, where are you? What's going on here? I will find you.
That's it for the first demonstration so far. So I really hope you like what you see, and I'm really looking forward to your comments. What comes next? My plan is to publish the Robo Eyes as an open source library, after some cleanup and final bug fixing, of course. Also, I'll finalize at least one robot in terms of design and functionality and produce it in high quality acrylic glass. I'm very curious to see what this will look like. And if you want to join me and my robots on this adventure, make sure to subscribe to the channel and if you like this video, I'd appreciate if you like it.